Hello and good morning here from the heart of hydraulics in Lower Main to the May edition of the web seminars from Industrial Hydraulics. Today, my colleague Dominik Rötsch and myself, we will inform you a little bit about ready to keep your automotive plant running. But before we go into details, I would like to explain to those of you that are new here today how this works. So these web seminars are an interactive session. It's not only a presentation. We want to integrate your feedback. We want to interact with you. That is why, besides of our live picture and the content that Dominik has prepared for you, in the lower section, you find a chat. And over there, you can write us your questions, your comments, your feedbacks, or like Constantino from Portugal, say hello, where you are at the moment, how you are. I hope you're all safe. And we also prepared some interactive questions to interact with you. So let's start with this, I would say. The first question to understand, where are you coming from? So are you automobile manufacturer, automobile supplier, service provider, or even from other areas? And if you have other areas, please write down also in the chat where you are coming from or where you're located. So yeah, we see Portugal and Spain and also China. Thank you for your feedback. I see that we have about 60 people in the line, so do not hesitate to give us your feedback. We want to have a little more interaction, so let us know what kind of business you're driving. Okay, it's coming up a little more. We have some automobile manufacturers already in the line, also from Saudi Arabia. I think the weather is better over there, and also in UK, where they have sun. It's nice to see that, Andrew. Okay, the second question now. What industry sector do you belong to? We have prepared the top five that we see for the moment, but of course, there may be other industry sectors, so please give us your vote. It's nice to have sun in UK.
Would be also nice to have it here.
Yeah. Okay. People coming from the presses area, presses section. I can already give you a hint that this is a good thing because we have prepared something, especially from the presses side, but also from others. Again, here, please let us know what kind of industry sector you're coming from. And then the third and last question. So what is the role inside the company? I saw already Tommaso, he's an hydraulic engineer, so from the design aspect, but I think we also addressed this to service and maintenance people. Let's see. A lot of sales guys, design, service maintenance. So again, we have about 60 people in the line. Please give us a little bit of feedback. We want to know who you are because we cannot see you, unfortunately. Okay. So I think it's already a first good impression. We have some manufacturers here. We have presses area and people from design and sales. So Dominik, talking about automotive and automotive plants, my first thought was, what do we have here? What can service help us there?
Yeah, there are of course many possibilities. We have a lot of nice things to show today, but before I start, I would like to introduce myself briefly.
Go ahead.
So yeah, hi everyone, my name is Dominik Rötsch. I'm responsible for the service sales support in the business unit Industrial Hydraulics. And what does it mean? It means we build the bridge between the customer, between service, and between sales. Mm-hmm. So what you will hear today is a journey. I want to take you on a journey today, a journey through the whole automotive plant and through some specific sections. So I want to show and explain you the warehouse, the presses area. Yeah, we have some people from the presses area. I want to show you the CNC machine tools and what we are offering as Service Industrial Hydraulics. And at the end, I also want to tell you what we can do and how we can support you, how we can service you in terms of the R&D test center or innovation center.
So you can be satisfied. I really can promise this is a very nice insight, but I think you will start a little bit with a portfolio overview, right?
Correct. So the first part will be the portfolio overview. What I also want to mention, I just said the focus today is on industrial hydraulics, service industrial hydraulics. But anyway, I want to mention that also, of course, the colleagues from the automation and electrification business unit, they have a lot of components in the automotive industry that we as Bosch Rexroth, of course, also can service. Anyway, focus will be on industrial hydraulics today.
Okay.
So before I start now, going into too much details, I would like to give you a short overview about our portfolio in the service. So for many people, quite often spare parts is the same as service. Yes, for sure, it's a very important part of it, I can tell you. Fully agree on that, and we offer 100% original parts. But there are many other services we can offer. For example, we offer repairs, and we offer it for the whole industrial hydraulics product portfolio. We offer field service. We have worldwide professional field service technicians that can help you in your factory at site. We offer retrofit. What does it mean? Well, we offer retrofit kits. It means we can exchange old components, buy new ones with a whole kit, including documentation, for example. We offer fluid management, so all about the oil analysis, a very important point in the hydraulics area. We offer digital services. It means like preventive, predictive analytics, but also like a service app. I will explain you later on a bit.
I remember the web seminar I've done with your colleague Michael some months ago on the digital services.
Yeah, correct. That was even deeper, with a lot of more details. We offer service agreements, service contracts, like a fixed price repair agreement. We'll also hear a little bit today. Then we offer industry service. What is behind that? Well, industry service for us is really taking over the whole maintenance activities in your factory, in your plant. For example, in the R&D test center. Then we have quality services. That is about having a professional warranty handling process. And of course, we are available with a service hotline 24/7 for sure.
Thanks for this overview. What I learned when I came to Rexroth 15 years ago already, we have a big worldwide service network, right? Oh, you show it already, sorry.
Correct. So we have a global network for sure, and it's very important to support you in Germany, in Europe, but of course also around the globe. And what we have, our global service network, is more than 2,000 service employees at Bosch Rexroth. I would say it's quite a lot to help you everywhere, to support you everywhere. And we are in more than 52 countries, and we have more than 200 service centers worldwide.
So Dominic, we see a lot of people come here from different countries. So let's get some feedback from them. How often they already had contact with you and the service department?
Yeah.
So next question for you guys. Did you ever work with Bosch Rexroth service? Yes, no, or maybe you hoped to do so, or maybe not to hope to do so. Service, good thing. Or if you even do not know the Bosch Rexroth service, we would like to understand. Okay, now we have more than 70 people on the line, still missing some feedback. Do not hesitate to give us your feedback. But it already looks like a huge majority already had some contact with you. So thank you for this short insight. Yeah, so that's basically, I would say, first startup. And let's dig a little deeper into the automotive section.
Yep. What I promised you and what I told in the beginning, I will take you on a journey. So let's start with the first area in an automotive plant. And of course, in many other plants, it's the warehouse. It's, of course, a crucial station. And for many people, as I said in the beginning, spare parts the same as service. And okay, the question is now, what else can we do instead of just selling from our side and buying from your side spare parts? Well, of course, for us, this is a very important topic to support you. And we call it spare parts management at service. And let me tell you a story how we could help a customer, how we helped a real customer, so it's a real success story, in order to improve the whole spare parts management in the automotive factory. Well, we started to analyze the customer requirements for all components from industrial hydraulics that are time critical. After that, we said, okay, how many of these components do we need on stock? And then we built up an exclusive safety stock. After that, we said, okay, the high-end solution, let's say, yeah, is to connect the customer directly to our service via EDI. That's also what we did.
EDI is this electronic data interchange, so the connection to the warehouse management and the procurement systems, right?
Absolutely correct. And this really saves a lot of time, so that it can be processed automatically. Of course, then also, you have all the track and trace functionalities and a very fast confirmation via email directly after you purchased the components. We also provided a clear contact person. That's very important because we need one responsible who is taking care about this project, about this topic. And the next step is, and that's also what we agreed at the end, okay, parameters are changing from time to time, of course. Sometimes you need then more, you need less, you need different components. So we agreed also having regular alignment meetings on the future performance. Do we need to adjust something? And if this is not enough, we have always another possibility, and that's the so-called digital service assistant app, where you have access to the documentation of spare parts, but you can also send directly a request via email.
So you see, Dominic also has put here the links to the store, so you can download it directly. Once you get the documentation of this web seminar, but you also can directly look into the stores and search for the digital service app. And one question to this analysis. So this is a very individual service. So this, the safety stock is individually and it's not initial. So you currently repeat it, right?
Yeah. Okay. So this is, of course, an offer to every one of you. Yeah. We want to discuss this topic with you and we want to help you in terms of spare parts management because it's a crucial topic in an automotive factory and also in many other factories.
Okay.
So we did it with this customer, we did it also with many other customers, and we want also to offer it to you.
So where do we go now on the journey from the spare parts?
Yes, this was the spare parts and just one of many examples. Let's go on our journey to the next station, the machine tools.
I think it's a basic machine in an automotive plant, right?
Absolutely. I would say almost every automotive plant, even every bigger automotive plant anyway, has CNC machine tools. Very important station. So let's see what we can do for you. Of course, there are many possibilities. What I would like to show you is the repair service because it's it's very common to do repairs on valves, on cylinders, on pumps, whatever hydraulic we have in these machines. And I would like to show you some repair services we offer because there is not one repair. And I would like to start with the most critical one, the most difficult one. It's called emergency repair. Mm-hmm. It means we do not have all spare parts on stock. Maybe we have some, but not all. But what we do is we anyway rebuild the functional condition that you can use again your machine because you know, downtime costs a lot of money. And you still get 12 months warranty on the exchange parts. And then we have the express repair. So you're asking probably yourself, what is the difference between emergency and express? Well, express is just a very fast repair. We can do it within a couple of hours, depending on the parts and on the damage, maybe within 1 to 2 days. And we offer you 12 months warranty on the whole product. And the big difference is now, it is technically a new product with original spare parts, 100%.
That's why we brought this here, I think. Dominic, you had very impressive exponents here. I put them on LinkedIn yesterday with a question. Yeah. So I think it's exactly what you said. So you want to tell me that this one here is not a new valve?
Correct.
Okay.
This is not a new one.
Okay. So what about this one? How long has this been used,
approximately? It has been used more than 10 years in the automotive industry.
Wow.
So it looks really old. And this is, as you said, not new and old. Mm-hmm. Yes, it is old, more than 10 years in use. Mm-hmm. But this is how it goes out from the service. And this is how it comes into the service.
For me,
so it's our back to new concept.
For me, it looks brand new.
It looks brand new and it is almost brand new.
Okay.
But it comes out from our service as back to new. And that's our concept.
Okay, cool.
And therefore also 12 months warranty on the whole product. Then we have the standard repair. So it's not urgent. Maybe you have some components on stock. That takes normally 8 days. You also get the 12 months warranty. And of course, again, technically as a new product. So as new with original spare parts. And then there is another possibility. And this is probably for the automotive industry the best possibility because it's an individual one. So we can individually agree on an agreement on a fixed price repair and a fixed price or other repair agreements in order to really serve you in the best way and to customize the offer specifically for you.
So before we leave here, I just saw there was a question on EDI from Tommaso, but your colleague Volker already answered it. So Tommaso, I hope this answered your question already. Okay, fixed price. I think there's something more to talk about.
Yes, so I said fixed price repair, individual agreement. Let's compare Because the question is always, does it make sense? Mm-hmm. What is the difference in comparison to not having an agreement? So let's have a look on it. If we have no service agreement, the main point is there is no calculation basis behind. It means there are no repair costs clear from the beginning, and you always have to request for a quotation. That, of course, takes time. And the costs for the inspection have to be covered at the end, because maybe you ask us for a quotation, we send it to you, and you are saying, okay, I don't want to repair it. And then we have costs for inspection. And number three is the throughput times are usually quite long. It means from the start to the beginning, but not only the repair time, the whole throughput takes about 25 days. Why? Because we have waiting times, so you have to approve the repair. We have questions that are related to the quotation, related to the approval. Sometimes we have questions, and also there might be technical clarifications. The big difference is, of course, if we have the agreement, we know the costs, you know the cost from the beginning, you can approve it from the beginning. We have a price list agreed between you and us. We have no costs for inspection because we just don't have to do an inspection. We agree already before that we do the repair without inspection. And the throughput times are about 8 working days. So this, of course, makes sense to think about a fixed price repair, especially if you have more than just a couple of components, and normally you have much more in an automotive plant or in an automotive factory.
And you have some examples here also to the right. So these were, I think, the little smaller components normally, correct, but yep. You see also bigger valves, and that's impressive, I would say. Should we proceed on the journey?
I would say let's proceed on our journey. And let me give you a little bit insights in one of our lead service centers. So we have the lead service center that is located in Lohr, and we have also many other service centers, as you heard in the beginning. I want to show you some KPIs, some figures. Yeah, for the spare parts, the lead service center in Lohr is at the same time the regional distribution center for Europe, for all the valve parts. So we have more than 20,000 material numbers on stock. I think this says something.
Wow.
From the standard delivery, you order today, we deliver tomorrow already. And if you say, I need it faster, express delivery, order today and we deliver it on the same day. And of course, let the figures speak. If we talk about the on-time delivery requested, so your requested delivery date that you ask for, we meet already 90%. And from our confirmed date, we meet 98%. And have a look on the assortment, we cover like 90%, so 89%. I think this is quite a lot.
So compared we have on stock, to the typical market followers?
This is really, really great.
Okay.
So yeah, we definitely have a great performance.
Impressive
compared to
numbers.
The
okay.
Let's have a look on the repair. We are the regional repair center in Europe for the valves in this location. So we do more than 20,000 repairs per year. We have, of course, flexible repair concept, as you heard. And one very important point I want to mention is we can also do a quick assembly of components in 1 to 2 days. It means in case there are no components on stock or the good can just not be repaired anymore because it's extremely old, you can ask us for doing a quick assembly of specific components and we can just do it in 1 to 2 days. Throughput time for our normal repair, I said 8 days. The confirmed delivery date we meet in 95% of the cases. And the third pillar in our lead service center is more than 3,000 field service operations per year.
The feet on the street.
The feet on the street, correct. So really, we are at site. We are in your factory in order to support you. And yeah, just having a look on a KPI, of course, the service hotline. Yeah, mm-hmm. To agree, for example, on a meeting is 24/7, 365 days per year available.
Great.
Very important point.
And we saw there are so many people from the presses area, and I promised there's something for them. So let's move to the presses.
Yep, let's move to the next part. That's presses. And let me start with a picture. I think every one of you, at least from the presses area, but also from the automotive industry, I'm sure, knows this picture. It's a typical press line. A normal press line has between like 4 and 6 presses. And it always starts with the lead press. And this is the press, I have to say, with the most stress, with the most heat. So this is really, mm-hmm. It requires a lot of maintenance. And let's have a look on the lead press. So I said, this is the press with the most stress and heat. And the press says, of course...
You can tell if you have a look at this one.
Correct. That will look even worse.
Yeah.
So we see we have different components in the lead press. We have, of course, we need a power unit, yeah, die cast power unit with cooling filtration system, cylinder system. We have electrical parts like overload protection. You also need the block control. Of course, you need a main drive, electrical main drive in this case, and also transfer and handling systems. And now you see a frame in red. And this is what I want to explain you a bit more, because I said within the press line, mm-hmm. the lead press is the press is the part with the most stress, mm-hmm. heat, speed, and also the most power. Mm-hmm. So you can say the lead press makes all the work. Mm-hmm. And within the lead press, the cylinder system, the so-called die cushion cylinder system, is the part with the most power.
Okay.
And let us have a look what can happen. You see here one of many possible damages, what can happen. This is a cylinder, yeah, die cushion cylinder, and you see a very high wear and tear on the cylinder seals.
That's the seal inside where you see this.
That's the seal, completely damaged.
Damaged.
And on the left side, you also see in like the brown color. It's not corrosion, by the way. It is just due to heat. So extreme conditions, and it's very important to know what to do in terms of presses, because otherwise, you can imagine, it costs a lot of money.
Talking about costs, do we have an estimation on what is a typical cost here on the automotive plant?
I know for sure that in an hour or per day, sometimes a couple of 100,000 euros, but we do not know exactly, especially not for the press line.
So let's ask again our participants maybe.
Let's ask our participants.
People from the automotive sector here. So let's see what you give us of feedback. Which unexpected downtime costs, unexpected per day, really per day? Do you calculate them per day? Okay.
Would be interesting, yeah.
In the value stream of a press line. So we have up to 100, 250 or even 500,000, yet that's euros, but it's, yeah. Let's say, for those who don't know the euro, yeah. It's close to dollar, of course. So the answers that are coming in still, it's up to 100, mm-hmm. but it could be even more. That's what you told me in the preparation. So I think we also should talk about prevention,
yeah.
because this is definitely something that you don't want to have in your daily stock. And oh, we come people coming up now, they're raising their bids. Thank you for this very open feedback. I think that's impressive. For me, it was impressive to learn that it's that high per yeah. day. Okay.
Yeah, very interesting. And the question is always talking about the maintenance, what to do? Should I overhaul mm-hmm. and I am still able to overhaul the system, or do I need a new one? Mm-hmm. Good question, and I would like to make a comparison. So what are the advantages of a standard overhaul? Well, of course, first of all, it's less expensive. You can save money. I agree on that, yeah? It's a bit faster normally, yeah? It, of course, takes more time to exchange all the components, so you save time. We, for sure, as Bosch Rexroth, use original parts. That's what we do because we are the original manufacturer. And the overhaul in our facilities, you have seen, mm-hmm. are usually as new. Of course, we have different models, but the standard is to have it as new. It also means, you heard it already, 12 months warranty at the end. But there are some reasons not to do an overhaul anymore. So the condition is very, very bad. Then it doesn't make sense to just overhaul it and repair it. You definitely need a new one. And we can support you with this decision. If you want to just increase productivity in terms of energy efficiency, in terms of CO2, for sure it makes sense to exchange the complete unit. And if you want to repair the old unit in order to put it on the safety stock, because we always recommend to have a safety stock, for sure it also makes sense in this case. So there are reasons for both. And we have to individually have a look on it together with us, with our experts, to decide what to do in a common decision. And what we can do, and this is very important, we can provide you with many maintenance recommendations mm-hmm. that we created together with automotive customers, with the mm-hmm. automotive industry, with manufacturers. And we can provide it to you, and we can even customize it to your specific situation. So this is an offer to you. Come to us, talk to us, and let us have a look what we can do and how we can improve it.
And based on these experiences, we talked about, let's say, not letting the damage happen and talking about prevention. I think there's something very special we have to offer. Some of yep. you may know the Odin, the Norwegian god.
Correct, yeah.
What does Odin mean?
Odin, it's always a good question. Okay. What do you think?
I wrote it down. Open Diagnostics Network.
Okay. I thought you want to tell the story about the God.
No. It's okay. So okay. Yeah, I think that's a very, very specific offering that we have here to, yeah, let's say, not even let the damage happen. So I think we, yeah, should dive a little deeper here.
Okay. Let me just tell you one point and give it just, yeah, one slide with you. So I don't want to go into too much details, but I just want to mention, you can find, later on you will get all the slides, and you can find also the names, typical OEMs with Rexroth die-cushion cylinders. That you also know, okay, if you are not 100% sure, do I really have Rexroth components in my presses? You can just have a look on the slide, and these are typical ones, yeah? There might be more, but the typical ones you can find here. So coming back to your question and, mm-hmm, to your point, mm-hmm, Open Diagnostics Network. We just heard about the press application. We heard and have seen that a lot of things can happen in terms of maintenance. And the big question is, and I think you even know Odin better than I do because you had already some web seminars on that.
Yeah, with your colleague Marcello.
Correct.
Almost 1 year ago, he told a little bit about it, but I'm quite sure that not everybody was here. So yeah, let's dive a little deeper, I would say.
Yeah, for sure. So Odin helps us to prevent and to predict before something happens. So to prevent machine breakdowns, for example. And a typical application would be the press. Let's have a look how our predictive analytics services called Odin, Open Diagnostics Network, works. So there is a six-step solution. It all starts, of course, with the data collection. We have somehow to collect the data. Can be done on the pump, for, mm-hmm, example, valve or cylinder. Depending on where are the most critical parts, we can discuss it together. Either you have already sensors in your press, or we can also retrofit your press with sensors. Then we need to transfer the data. It goes into the Bosch cloud in a very safe way. Of course, coded and only in one direction. Then we need to process the data. We do it with artificial intelligence behind. There is an algorithm. And then we, of course, send you from time to time regular status reports. And the main point is we can give you maintenance recommendations. What you should do and when should you repair this pump, exchange this cylinder and whatever. And this is very important in order to prevent such machine breakdowns. And for sure, we can combine this solution, Odin, with further possibilities, with further services like you heard about the fixed price repair agreement or also a spare parts management topic.
And I think when you talked about experiences and now the artificial intelligence, so that's a consistently learning system, yeah, right? So the, correct, more data you get in, the more you learn and the more clear and precise your maintenance recommendation is.
Absolutely. So it's a self-learning system. And the more time it takes, the more it is learning automatically. So it's artificial intelligence.
Okay, I see there's a question coming in from Raman. Can we get price of service category items online? I think yes, via the eShop, for example.
Could be on the eShop, correct. Mm-hmm. This is what I'm thinking. And you can also get in contact with us afterwards, and we will, of course, provide you the prices you need.
Okay. So you still can, as if you have shown the link to the spare parts catalog,
yeah,
all these spare parts are linked to our local eShop, or, correct, to your local eShop, basically. And you can, if you're an eShop user, you can already get the pricing, your individual pricing for, yeah, these items.
Yeah.
So we move on very fast through the automotive plant, now coming from the presses to the test center. Yeah. Interesting area also, I would say.
Correct. And the last station, after we have seen many production areas, let's say, mm-hmm, now we are in the test center. Could also be an innovation center. So many automotive factories also have own test stations, own test centers. And I want to show you one example, what we can do. First, I would like to start explaining what is industry service. So for us, industry service is an offer that we take over the whole maintenance activities. It means we have dedicated people, dedicated field service technicians that are for a certain time in your factory, in your plant, in your test center, and they can take over the maintenance activities and everything that is related to it in order to make sure that your machines are running. And in this case, we implemented completely all maintenance activities and modifications, was taken over by our service technicians on all hydraulic test benches that are, by the way, 24/7 in operation, so, mm-hmm, quite a long time.
Mm-hmm.
And this we did in the technology centers of the automotive company. And that's what we can offer. Yeah, especially we have huge experience in the technology centers. in the R&D in order to provide you the know-how. So you can take our know-how directly in your plant, in your factory.
Sounds good. So now we had several stations in an automotive plant. Could you sum up a little bit the major advantages?
Yeah. So let's have a look on the main points. Because the question is always at the end, why should I choose Bosch Rexroth instead of other smaller, normally, service providers? Of course, we are acting globally. You have seen and you have heard we have a global service network. We have a warranty that is called back to new. So you get a technically new product together with the warranty. Talking about the global network, it's not only a global network. You have also local contacts who can speak your language. That's very important. Mm-hmm. We are certified according different standards. That's for sure. And you can imagine that also our own Bosch Rexroth standards are really high. We have fixed prices that we offer and low TCOs.
Total cost of ownership.
Total cost of ownership, correct. And therefore also minimal liability risks. Why? Because we are the original manufacturer. If we cannot repair our own products with original parts, who else should do it? Who should do it better than we do with our own original test benches, our own standards, certifications, and our own parts? And of course, the experience in the automotive industry that we have is huge. So we are in many, many automotive manufacturers with many components, but also for automotive suppliers we are working with in service and also in different other areas.
Okay, I see here there's somebody who raised their hand, so you don't need to raise your hand, just type in your question and then we are able to answer your question right now. So I think this was very impressive. We got a very impressive first insight into a very specific focus area, which are the automotive plants, and I think you clearly summed up what are the experiences. And as I said already, so the participants, they will get the feedback via this registration. But is there any more that you can find online? Any more information?
Yeah, there are many information you can find online.
Okay, that's good.
Many topics. We have brochures, we have blog posts, we have white papers. Mm-hmm. We are for sure also active on LinkedIn, and we have also other webinars. So if you are interested in Odin, for example, you can find the webinar for Odin. And what I always want to offer you is get in contact with us, either on different channels or directly with us via phone, via email. Let us meet and let us discuss all these topics, because within such a short time today, I can only give you some small insights and we can do an even bigger and better journey together.
Okay. So what I really like that you put in your LinkedIn address here, so people can get directly back to you.
Young generation.
Yeah, with questions, exactly. But also even older people use
that. Yeah, correct.
So unfortunately, we don't have too many questions, but people are typing. So let's wait for some more seconds to see. But thanks again already. I like this very impressive envisioning here with these exponates, and also the clear pointing out of the stations. So let's wait for a second more to see if there's a question coming in. But in the meantime, I would like to at least say to you that these web seminars can be found online on our website. So there's an area called Connected Hydraulics. You can find all of them, or you can directly go into YouTube, go to the Rexroth channel, and you find also everything that we had summed up for the moment. So yeah, now questions coming in from Tommaso again. Do you give training courses for Odin?
Yeah, let me understand the question a bit. Training courses, you mean that we give you more insights about Odin?
Or I think maybe using it, and that's what I would understand. So yeah, how's the typical onboarding of the customer with Odin?
Yeah, for sure. The first thing is that you make a meeting with a sales colleague, maybe also with a technician, to discuss to see your machine. So you tell us, okay, this is a typical line I want to make a bit better. I want to predict. I want to know what happens. So then we have a look on it, like on a press.
Okay.
Then we start having a look on the wiring diagrams. So we want to know, okay, what is behind, where to place which sensor, how can we retrofit it. Then we discuss it, we make an offer. And of course, if you decide for that later on, you will be a bit trained on that system to also understand it. But the good thing is, you don't have to do it by your own. So there is an artificial intelligence behind. You get the status reports. You get all the information you want to have and you need. But but we have an own service team, we have own experts that can provide you with the information that will tell you what to do and when to do. And this will be discussed, and this is of course a kind of a training for sure.
Okay, cool. So it looks like we got the question answered. So again, thank you very much for your input here. And okay, question was answered. And thank you also for participating today. I would like to ask you to fill out our follow-up questions on how you like this webinar. We want to become even better, but we also want to know if we fit your expectations today. I think we got a good mixture between broad information but very specific insights. So I hope you like it, and hope you stay safe. See you in about 1 month for the web seminar here in Industrial Hydraulics. Thank you so much and have a good time.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.